this is Dr. Thomas Jackson with M.E.E.T Ministry in the Natural Pharmacy today. I'm in my house, in my kitchen, and I'm going into my refrigerator because I have something in my refrigerator that is both culinary and medicinal that you might be very familiar with. And as I reach in here and especially pull these items out, and we realize it is garlic. You know, most of people realize that garlic is not a very sociable food. And I mentioned that it's both culinary and medicinal. Culinary because we use it for seasoning. We give flavor to it. But I just want to talk to you about garlic. And also I have something in my hand called olive oil. And I'm going to just give you a simple recipe. But before we do that, garlic contains medicinal property that is very preventive. And also, when I say preventive, it's prophylactic. Also, it has curative properties to it. And one of the compounds in garlic is sulfur. And why is sulfur so important? Because garlic also can help the repairing of the DNA of the cell. And when we deal with cancer, cancer is nothing but an altered DNA. One of the things that we want to understand or do is to help to repair and strengthen the DNA. And garlic has the medicinal property to do that, alongside with other phytochemical properties. Now, another important aspect of garlic, as some might know, it has a phytochemical property called allicin. Allicin is what gives the odor. Most people go to the health food store and buy odorless garlic because they do not want to be antisocial because of the odor. But they're really not getting their money worth because the property that's in the garlic, the allicin, is what gives the very preventive properties to it. Because I have a garlic in my hand, you don't smell it. But once we open it and crush it, it releases that compound called allicin. And that is what gives the power. Now, I'd rather be antisociable and be healthy. But let me give you one point. If you're concerned about that, before I give you this simple recipe, when you eat your grapefruit, my wife always encouraged me to eat grapefruit, take the seeds and put it in the freezer. And when you eat the garlic, take seeds out of the freezer and chew on the seeds of the grapefruit, spit them out, that will make you more sociable. Are you with me? All right, so what about garlic and olive oil? One of my favorite recipes is garlic oil. 1 cup of chopped garlic, 1 cup, chop it up, put it in a glass container, find some pure, virgin, unpasteurized olive oil. Pour 3 cups over the chopped garlic in a glass container, put a lid on it, leave it out for 7 days, and you're going to shake that solution every day for 7 days to absorb the medicinal property into the oil. It's like an osmosis process. And after 7 days, you're now going to pour the oil, strain it into a glass jar, and preferably an amber jar, something that's dark, to keep it protected from the rays of the sun. Mm-hmm. And then you can refrigerate that. Now, that is your garlic oil. Finally, what is this good for? Well, number one, earaches. You know, when you use it, you just want to be sure it's room temperature, 2 or 3 drops in the ear for infection. Garlic, remember, is antibacterial. Garlic is antiviral, cholesterol-lowering properties. So you can use it for earaches. What about those mouth sores? You say, what about the bad breath after you use the garlic? Remember the grape seed. Put the garlic on the mouth sore. It's very good for that. Ringworms. Are you familiar? Fungus on the toenail and the fingernails. Infection in the stomach. These are some of the medicinal properties. And finally, outside of being medicinal, you know what else you can use it for? I use it to put it on my salad. Makes it delicious. And not only that, I love garlic bread. Can you imagine the aroma putting on garlic bread? What food can you use medicinally and culinary? You see, I have many more of these wonderful recipes in my book, God's Pharmacy. So this is Dr. Thomas Jackson. I want you to join me next time in the Natural Pharmacy.